Hey guys, your boy B-Minus, and welcome to the Career Mode Update for April 24, 2015. And thank God we got a way better show than we had for you last week. If you guys remember from last week, it was just massive downgrades, but we got some pretty good upgrades this week, as well as some hidden gems. Remember, the hidden gem show will be on Wednesday, but right now we're going to hit you with the big names, with the big movers and shakers right here. And if you guys enjoyed this series, if it's helping you out, remember to go ahead and smash that like button and go ahead and share it with all your friends who love Career Mode as much as I love Without further ado, let's go ahead and get it in. First up is the buff section, and this man literally gets an upgrade every single week. I think it's an EA's contract to upgrade him every single week. As you can see, he's not getting anything huge, no plus ones, but once again, he is getting upgrades right here. A +2 to shot power and a +2 to strength, bringing him up to a monstrous 85 in strength. He's getting a +1 agility and +2 to balance, so not huge upgrades, but he's just getting better and better and better. Look at this. This man, he's gonna be freaking 88 in sprint speed, 82 acceleration, and 85 in strength with 84 stamina. Whoo, this boy is gonna be bad. A guy that I profiled a couple of weeks, I think he was on one of the first career mode updates we ever did. He was getting a -1 back then because he was coming back from injury, and now that he is back and he is in form for FC Bayern, he is getting a +1 upgrade just like I predicted right here. Let's go ahead and take a look at his stats right here. Getting a +5 to volleys, +5 to stamina. That stamina is always the first one to get knocked after they come off the injury, and he is back in form. Still not all that great with only 66 in the stamina, but that's to be expected. He's primarily coming off the bench, I think, right now. Getting a +1 dribbling and a +2 to reactions. Not all that bad. Still has that injury prone trait, which isn't all that nice, but it's good to see Thiago back in form. This one I feel is long overdue, and I don't know why they haven't upgraded him more, guys. Charlie Austin has just been one of has been the one bright star for Queen's Park Rangers this year, and it's probably the Queen's Park Rangers QPR is probably gonna go down, but I think Charlie Austin is definitely gonna move to one of the bigger sides right here. And he's just had a great season, and it's a well-deserved +1. If it was up to me, I'd probably give him a +1, +2, or +2. I don't know. Let's go ahead and take a look at the upgrades. That he's getting a massive upgrade in shot power right there, +7 to shot power, and he's already got decent strength, but getting a little bit of a buff there, and is getting a buff in the defending sense. I don't know why that's really getting too much of a buff, but it's not all that great. They're only in the 30s and the 20s. +5 to crossing and +5 to volley, so not a huge upgrade, but an upgrade nonetheless. Hopefully he gets another one before the end of the season. Charlie Austin, the man with the tiny shin pads and loves to suck on nitrous balloons, Jack Grealish. Oh man, he has just been lightning in a bottle ever since that he has starting for the Aston Villans right here, and he is getting a well-deserved overall upgrade to his overall +2 and overall and potential upgrade of 2. 4-star skill moves, 3-star weak foot, age of 18, is only 5'10". Let's go ahead and take a look at his stats, guys. As you see, very nice upgrades right here. A +3 to stamina. Unfortunately, it is only at a 64, but a plus to stamina I am always game for. Unfortunately, getting a -4 to interceptions, but a +4 in both vision and positioning, as well as a +5 to his short passing, and a +1 to his balance and reactions, as well as long passing. So as you see right here, he's not all that great of a player just yet. Remember, he is going to be rated at a 68, but he will grow immensely into an 82. One of the best young talents in the English Premiership, Jack Grealish. Another guy who's just been playing well all season when given the shot, and this is banned, Sadio Mane of Southampton, is getting a +1 to overall and potential. Got a 4-star skill move, 3-star weak foot, and he is just a pace abuser, guys. Go ahead, getting a +1 to sprint speed, as well as a +1 to finishing, giving him a very respectable 75 in finishing. Got the speedster, the diver, tries to be defensive line, selfish, and flair traits, decent dribbling, as well as ball control. And there you go, guys. Not all that huge of an upgrade, but pretty good discount buy striker if you need someone who's a little bit pacey and pretty decent on the wings, Sadio Mane. And for all my Polish fans this week, I apologize, and I'm about to butcher this name, Grzegorz Krychowiak. Yeah, close enough. Anyway, the man from Poland plays for Sevilla Football Club in La Liga, is getting a +1, pushing his overall to the 80 club. 3-star weak foot, 6'1". And let's look at his stats. He's actually getting a -2 in short passing, which isn't that good, but a +3 in heading accuracy, 4 in long passing, 3 in aggression and interceptions, and a whopping +9 to penalties and a +1 to strength and marking. Well done, my son. As the injury free trait, which is always nice to have, as well as the long passer trait and the strength speciality, a little bit slow. It's very rare that you actually find me profile someone who has 55 acceleration and 63 sprint speed, but look at those monstrous defensive stats. Remember, he does play the CDM position, and you look very nice long shots as well as decent shot power. He's going to be a good little CDM for you guys. 24, getting a little bit long in the tooth for me, but a very, very good player right there in the CDM position. Last in the buff section, a guy that I was thinking about holding off for the hidden gem section, but there wasn't too much to talk about in this week's big name, so I thought I'd go ahead and drop a little bit of a hidden gem early, and that is that man, Donis Avdijaj, I'm guessing is how you say his name. And yes, he is German, and he's getting the biggest upgrade of the week with a +4, +4 monstrous in overall and potential 4-star weak foot, 3-star skill moves. 5'8", not the tallest for a German, and we're going to go ahead and look at his stats. Massive upgrades all around. As you can see, really good upgrades in the attacking, +12, +4, +7. +1, +8 to stamina. You always gotta love that. +2 to long shots. +14 to long passing. +5 to dribbling. +3 to sprint speed. And +7 to acceleration, to name a few. Has the tries to beat defensive line trait. And a +17 to vision as well as positioning. As you can see right now, not all that great. Not all that great. Just kind of decent in these stats. But the thing that you have to look for is he is only at a 63. Remember, boys, he is only at a 63. And he's gonna grow to an 84. So that is a growth of 21 points, guys. He is going to be an absolute monster. If you want to go ahead and buy a nice, cheap, young German striker, go ahead and get Donis Avdijaj. Just get Donis. And now for the nerf section, and the poor man. Everyone's shitting on him, so why not EA? And I can't argue with him. He deserves this -1, -1. How the mighty have fallen. Good old Stevie G is getting a -1, -1 right here. Let's go ahead and take a look at his stats that are being downgraded. Not all that bad, just a -4 to his interceptions. He still has all these really good traits right here, and as well as a decent speciality. It's just getting a little bit long in the tooth, and he has definitely dipped in form this year. It's sad to see a legend die, but I'll get to see him next year when he plays in LA. Next up, Liverpool's been on a little bit of a downturn, so as it goes, usually their players get a little bit of a downgrade. That has to do with Mamadou Sakho right here getting a -2 to his potential. Let's go ahead and take a look. He's actually getting a little bit of a negative and positive, getting a -4 to ball control and a +2 to jumping, though, so that's not too bad. Still is a pretty good overall player, just doesn't have that high end potential anymore, and I can't argue with that. Next, and thankfully last, because if you guys remember last week, there's so many players that were getting nerfed. This week, a lot better, not too many getting nerfed, and this is going to be the last one I'm talking about. Pedro Franco can play the center back as well as the CDM position. 6 foot, is getting a -1, -1. The Colombian plays for Bissetask. JK, just kidding. Okay. terrible. As you can see, some pretty nasty downgrades. A -5 to jumping is never all that great, as well as a -2 to interceptions. I guess he got his vision up a little bit better, but a -2 to slide tackle, a -2 to marking, and -1 to balance, not all that great. Dives into tackles, and he has a leadership role, so that's not all too bad. 23-year-old Pedro Franco getting the nerf bat. And that is it, guys, for the crew mode update for April 24, 2015. I want to give you guys a little bit of update that I will be streaming tomorrow during the Manchester United game. So go ahead and hit me up on Twitch at B-Gamer. And go ahead and follow me on Twitter at B-Gamer so I can keep you guys up to date on all that goody goodness. And remember to go ahead and share this video. Smash that like button if it's helping you guys out. And until next time, my name's B-. And hope you guys are having an amazing day. And remember, stay humble.